Such that if you forgive the faults of others, your heavenly Father will forgive you yours. If you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive you. When you fast, you are not to look glum as the hypocrites do. They change the appearance of their faces so that others may see they are fasting. I assure you they already repaid. When you fast, see to it that you groom your hair and wash your face. In that way, no one can see you are fasting, but your Father who is hidden, and your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you. Do not lay up for yourselves an earthly treasure. Moths and rust corrode, thieves break in and steal. Make it your practice instead to store up heavenly treasure, which neither moths nor rust corrode, nor thieves break in and steal. Remember where your treasure is, there your heart is also. Determined to destroy Will Wheaton. And so instead, So later on, Will Wheaton is brought in as a rigger on a bowling team. Sheldon and his friends are on one bowling team, and Will Wheaton is on the other bowling team. And Will Wheaton can see Sheldon is so furious that he at one point says to him, "I am in your mind right now." And of course, Sheldon bluffs him and rolls a cover. Because Will Wheaton was in his mind. Now, why was Will Wheaton in his mind? Is because Sheldon was unable to forgive Will Wheaton. Because those little things that in Will Wheaton's life were insignificant, for Sheldon, it was everything. And indeed, Will Wheaton was living in his mind and controlling him, all because Sheldon could not forgive and would not forgive. Today's gospel reminds us of the necessity of forgiveness. All of us in our lives have people who have offended us, who have angered us, who have sometimes deeply hurt us or tried to destroy us. But if we do not choose to forgive that person becomes for us like Will Wheaton is to Sheldon. And that sin, that affront, that mark of disrespect takes control of us and leads us into bondage and in ever further into sin. It's as simple as that. Most people in our society falsely believe that forgiveness is a feeling, that I have to feel like I'm going to forgive someone. The word feeling appears no place in the New Testament. No place. No place. That's why Christ tells us if we don't forgive, that we will be the ones who are responsible for our own lack of forgiveness. And every time we pray the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father, we ask for that to take place. Because we pray, "And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us." Or as a clearer translation would be, "Forgive us as we forgive others." So if we don't forgive, if we do not choose to forgive those who have offended us, those who have hurt us, those who have sinned against us, no matter how terrible it might be, we cannot be healed, nor can we be forgiven our anger or our hatred. That's how serious Jesus Christ is about forgiveness. We see the greatest mark of his forgiveness when he's nailed to the cross and he says, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing." There is not a single person here, including myself, does not have someone that is in they want it. They may not. They may not even be sorry. They may not even care. But you and I are called upon as followers of Christ to decide to forgive, no matter how heinous the sin may be. Now that is a challenge from the gospel. A great and overwhelming challenge that can only take place in so many other parts of life in Christ can take place. Only if you and I are open to the grace of the Holy Spirit pouring into our hearts and changing us every single day. Let's not be like Sheldon, unable to forgive, and having the person who has offended us taking over our lives and indeed preventing us from being saved. Instead, let us look at what our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ has done and has called upon us to do for forgiveness.
Mercy. Oh, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God. Spirit, the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, often to my treasure of heaven. shall take for your iniquities and shall cleanse you of your sins. Save your people, O God, and bless your inheritance.
We have seen God's good light. We have received the heavenly spirit. We have found the true faith, and we worship Him for His purity. For the truth He has saved us.
Blessed is our God, always, now and ever, and forever. Forgive each other. day of the great fast is Monday, on March the 3rd. We will have a prayer service of 11 for the great fast at 7 p.m. on Monday evening. Wednesday evening, the cantors will lead the Akathist or the Paraclist service at 7 p.m. And then on Friday at 7 p.m., we will have the Liturgy of the Pre-Sanctified Gifts. So let us begin this great fast with the forgiveness that is necessary for us to make this truly a great fast. Any other important announcements for the bulletin? So please be sure to read it. Thank you to Laetare for the marvelous singing this evening, and please also come and join us over in the church hall.
Glory to you, Christ our hope, glory to you.
Our God-loving Bishop John, to the workers, to the singers, and to all the parishioners,